Speakeasy. Connect with every conversation. Written and narrated by Lou Diamond. About the Author was narrated by Isabelle McLeod-Daphnis. The additional bonus conversation includes Adrienne Bankert and Lou Diamond. Janet, my love, my life, and the easiest person to speak to. Intro. One good conversation can shift the direction of change forever. Linda Lamb. After taking over a dozen looks at herself in the hotel room's mirror, Sarah glanced at her watch and realized she was going to be late. She cursed a few times and grabbed her iPhone, her key card, and her event conference badge with its blue ribbon attachment that read, Speaker. She dashed down the long corridor, jumped into the elevator, repeatedly pressed the casino lobby button until the doors shut, and prayed she'd have an express ride. The elevator arrived after no stops, and Sarah dashed through the lobby in her steam-pressed dress and 5-inch heels. She had the length of 5 football fields to cover to get to the conference center of the Aria Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. "Excuse me, which way to the main ballroom?" she hurriedly asked a random group of lanyard-wearing conference attendees. After some general uncertainty and a non-committal, "down that corridor" directive, Sarah again checked her watch and saw she'd be cutting it close, but was going to be okay after all. Upon reaching the main hall entrance, she met eyes with the event producer, who was equally panicked about Sarah's arrival time. The producer hurriedly guided her toward a back pathway adjacent to the main ballroom and began weaving the wires and cords of a lavalier microphone down her back and into an inconspicuous location beneath her dress that would be out of view of the audience. Standing backstage, Sarah had a few minutes before she was to deliver her speech as the featured keynote speaker of a multi-day conference. She was pumped and extremely nervous, as this would be the largest audience she had ever addressed. The bustling sound of over 4,000 people finding their seats was now evident to Sarah. She heard the event's MC letting everyone know all about the next speaker. Sarah was tempted to peek through the side curtain to view the audience, but thought better of it and began her pre-game routine. She closed her eyes, took a few slow, deep breaths, and appreciated the moment. While she tried to deploy her recently discovered meditation exercises, she had too many thoughts racing and wasn't able to settle her mind. In particular, one thought repeated, "How did I get here?" Instead of dismissing it, she decided to retrace the memories of what had brought her to this moment as a way to relax herself before going on stage. She remembered her excitement to fly to Las Vegas in an upgraded business class seat. Before that, she neatly packed her Away-branded carry-on bag, her onstage outfit placed inside without a crease. Prior to that were numerous coordination efforts with the event team to prep for her presentation. Before that were many rehearsals of her speech and video conference calls with the event planning team to craft a message that would connect to this year's theme. Months before, she delivered a final pitch presentation to the event planning committee tasked with selecting their featured speaker. Even further back in time, she received an email from that very same committee asking her to submit a proposal to speak at this conference. And weeks before that email was a phone call. One simple call with the head of sales for one of the largest companies in North America, who wanted to learn more about Sarah. That was it. Sarah recognized that was where it all began, with just one conversation. One conversation that established a connection. One conversation that began a relationship. One conversation that sparked an idea. One conversation that opened the door for Sarah to share her brilliance. One conversation that created the possibility that Sarah would be able to help this executive sales team with her message. One conversation that stimulated the idea that Sarah could be a fantastic speaker to keynote the company's upcoming global conference. Remembering that initial conversation and the connection she made, Sarah smiled, took a breath, and walked onto the stage to thunderous applause. one great conversation. Each one of us, in our own way, strives to have moments like Sarah did on her big day. We all remember and rejoice in the milestones and memories that greatly impact our lives. But we can all feel so frazzled and swept up in the moment that we forget how we arrived here. Sarah was able to retrace her long journey to the big stage, this pivotal moment in her career, to one great conversation. Was she right? When you think about every business relationship you have made in your life, every friendship, all of the meaningful connections you have created, they all began with an engaging conversation where you connected with someone or some group of people. Great conversations are at the heart of the great connections in our lives. Conversations have the power to inspire, motivate, engage, and educate us. Conversations start the engine so we can drive toward the connections we desire to make. And because of their strength and value, we plan our days around them. We seek out new ways to have better, deeper, more authentic conversations that will enrich our lives. I think Sarah was onto something. But I also know that not every conversation is a great conversation. Many times, we fail to make a strong connection when speaking with another. That promising lead turns out to be a bust. That first date we were excited about doesn't lead to a second. That hard conversation we led doesn't result in change for either party. Nor did that sales pitch we gave land the prospective client. Not all conversations lead to a great result, a triumph, or a win. But what if they could? What if you knew the key elements that have the potential to make every conversation great? What if you knew the steps to set up each conversation to increase the likelihood that you connect, engage, and win? What if you had a roadmap to guide each of your good conversations into great ones? Speakeasy. During the Prohibition era, underground and illegal bars called speakeasies emerged. They received their name from police officers who had trouble locating the bars because patrons tended to speak quietly, at the bartender's request, while inside the hidden drinking spots. Many of these venues were secret, often the back rooms of legitimate storefronts, requiring secret passwords or special knocks to be allowed inside. Today, you have been granted entry into a very special speakeasy. On tap are not the usual alehouse lagers or bathtub gins. Nor will I, as your guide and de facto mixologist, serve up anything illegal or of ill repute. Rather, you will be given access to some of the best-kept secrets of some of the world's elite interviewers and conversationalists. You have a front-row seat to a storyteller and professional speaker who has rehearsed, presented, and studied how content can connect and engage audiences. You have tapped the ear of a podcaster who has listened, conducted, reviewed, dissected, analyzed, edited, and broken down thousands of interviews and great conversations. You have exclusive access to a sales professional and trainer who has captured proven strategies, tactics, and lessons and distilled them into this simple, easy-to-understand book. In this speakeasy, you will learn the skills and develop the tools you need to increase the likelihood that more of your conversations lead to great connections. Speakeasy will address the mindset you should strive to be in before, during, and after you have a conversation, as well as how to prepare, maximize, and continue a great conversation. Speakeasy will show you how to utilize a conversation to connect with prospects, engage with partners, clients and colleagues, and win in business and in life. Connect, engage, and win. At the end of each chapter is a section titled Connect, Engage, and Win, in which you will find tips, techniques, and best practices utilized by some of the world's greatest communicators and leaders. The suggestions in these sections are specifically geared toward connecting with business prospects and targets. You will receive tips for engaging your audience to win the sales, deals, and relationships you need to get your business to thrive. Think of Speakeasy as your playbook to tap into the unlimited potential that lies in every conversation. Your seat at the bar is waiting for you. Come on in, be cool, and learn something new. Chapter 1. Conversations Matter. Can we talk? Joan Rivers. Welcome. I'm so glad you decided to visit this fine establishment. I want you to have a very relaxed and enjoyable time as you take in all that I have to offer. While I begin to pull together a few creative concoctions for you, I think it'll help if I provide you with a little background as to what this specific speakeasy is all about. What counts as conversation? We are enamored with conversations. We enjoy listening to conversations we aren't even a part of, eavesdropping on the conversations of others. We react, laugh, cry when hearing conversations that resonate with us. We tune in to primetime television to watch people have conversations. We scour the internet and watch videos of interviews and conversations. We listen to hundreds, if not thousands, of podcast interviews. We are consistently drawn into conversations from every direction. On any given day, you have numerous interactions and conversations. Your partner and kids in the morning, your driver or train conductor, your barista, your colleagues at the office. The Courage Beer Conversations survey conducted in Britain in 2010 showed that the average person has more than 25 conversations each day. When we traditionally think about the word conversation, we think of two people speaking to one another. But here's how the dictionary defines it. A talk between two or more people in which thoughts, feelings, and ideas are expressed, questions are asked and answered, or news and information is exchanged. So a conversation can take place among a group of people, like within a small team gathering or even a group presentation. One could even go so far as saying that a conversation is taking place when someone is speaking to a large audience and interacting with them, like a keynote speaker presenting to several hundred or thousand attendees. Even a virtual presentation, in which a presenter delivers a message digitally and interactively, could be considered a conversation. The lessons you'll take in here address all of these types of conversations that we encounter in our personal and professional lives. We need conversations. Because of how commonplace conversations are, I suspect that most people take for granted the ones they have each day. However, since conversations are one of the means through which we can learn, develop, and be informed, they are an essential part of our daily survival. Simply put, we need conversations to live. Conversations are key to language development and the exchange of thoughts and ideas. People learn empathy by hearing each other's thoughts while observing facial and body expressions that show emotions. In her book, Reclaiming Conversation, The Power of Talk in a Digital Age, Sherry Turkle writes, "Face-to-face conversation is the most human and humanizing thing we do. Fully present to one another, we learn to listen. It is where we develop the capacity for empathy. It's where we experience the joy of being heard and of being understood. Conversation advances self-reflection. The conversations with ourselves that are the cornerstone of early development and continue throughout life. Plus, it turns out, we equally desire to have conversations as part of our social fabric. Harvard psychology professor Daniel Gilbert co-authored a study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. Within the study's conclusions, Gilbert stated, "Humans are the most social animal on the planet, and conversation is the bread and butter of social life. We may not live by bread alone, but we die without it." In summary, we are social beings, and we truly need to have conversations to thrive. We love conversations. Conversations are like a refreshing beverage that quenches our thirst to connect with others. And the enlightenment, sense of empathy, and appreciation that we derive from being involved in a conversation makes us want to continue to have more of them. Here's the cool thing about conversations. We don't even need to be the ones having a conversation in order to enjoy it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.